Thank you. We bless your name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let our hearts say amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We are here this afternoon to celebrate the life of Anika Stevens. It is a bittersweet moment. So we, the church, we are here to give hope and comfort to the families, neighbors, friends, co-workers, well-wishers, and also to give a message of salvation. Some might say, why? And how did this happen? But we are here to give you some assurance that God is still here, He is still in control, and He is good, and His mercies endure forever. He knows all things, He holds the future. And as believers, we know even in tragedy, even in death, God still is in control. His mercies is everlasting. It may feel like something has ripped apart from you. Some treasure has been lost. But I pray today that God will fill that void in your life. I pray that you will find some source of comfort. Death is no respect to a person. But I want to assure you today that when we leave this place, we need to know where we are spending our eternity. Hebrews 9:27 says, as it is appointed unto man once to die, but after death, there is judgment. Anika Stephen has gone so soon, but she will not be forgotten. And I pray today that you will make God your refuge and your strength, because He is a very present help in time of need. Find strength. Find some place where you can plug in and find that grace, that joy, that peace, that comfort. And you can only find it in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen? Without any further ado, I just want to welcome Tahira Tyson as we open for tributes.
Good afternoon, everyone. So we know the occasion for which we are gathered in this place is a very sad one. And at this time, we know the families would need your prayers, your words of encouragement and comfort. Therefore, we open the floor and invite tributes from the members of the audience. To enter the stage, you may ascend the stairs on my right, and you will exit on my left. So if you have a poem, a song, a memory you'd like to share, or just words of encouragement, please feel free to ascend the stairs and share. The family need you. They will appreciate you. So you may do so first. You may do so now. To begin, I see the students of the Boca Secondary School who would like to share a song with the family members. Students of the Boca Secondary School. So the students would like to sing a song entitled One Sweet Day.
Sorry. Sorry, I never told you all I wanted to say, and now it's too late to hold you, 'cause you've flown away, so far away, yeah. Never had I imagined living without your smile, feeling and knowing you hear me keeps me alive, alive. Assumed you'd always be there, but I took your presence for granted. Always there, I miss the love you share.
Thank you, ladies from the Boca Secondary School. Thank you very much. As they descend, I'd like to call to the stage to pay tribute to the family of Anika Stevens, the Grenada Cadet Corps, a representative from the Grenada Cadet Corps to do a tribute. Let's welcome her as she comes. It's not easy to do this. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. For the last 12 years, I've known myself as Mo, as Larry, sorry, when it comes to Anika, which we called Mo. And the name came about in reference to the Three Stooges. We would always get into trouble together, that's in Cadet. And Anika, for some reason, always had the innocent face, but she was the one behind all the planning. So she came with the name, she had the name Mo. Then next friend, Crystal, Curly. For some reason, Anika decided to name her Curly because she always was short and fluffy. And then me, Larry. Out of everything, Anika would call me Larry because she said I was missing hairline. So that way she called me Larry. But however, we were close, very close. For my teenage years, I remember most of my first stuff, I've experienced it with Anika. My first lip gloss, I got it from Anika. The first time I shaved my eyebrows, I got it from Anika. We did a lot together. I even remember in cadet camps, funny how it is, we were climbing the roof in Happy Hill Secondary School to go over to the next side and mush people. Then we would have camp, and in cadets, you're not supposed to have colored hair and those kind of stuff, but anybody who knows Anika is the beauty queen. And Anika would come to camp with a colored hair, and she would put a stocking cap over it, and nobody cannot tell her anything. Anika would even, if somebody fret me or fret somebody, Anika say, no, we're going and tell them about it, we're doing something about it, whatever. Go to tell whoever about it, Anika shut down. Anika say, are you doing that, you know? That was Anika. Even in, we went to Dominica, and for some reason, I ended up in trouble, and I had to carry the pot up the mountain. And for the 2 days we were in the bush, I was a laughing stock because I had to carry the pot. So Anika would make all the joke about me, all kind of stuff. We went on the beach in Dominica, and we were playing a game, you know, I think it was Truth or Dare or whatever, a game. And everybody, you had to ask them questions about yourself. And for some reason, Anika would ask you the worst set of questions. Just so that Anika would win the game, Anika would ask us, what's her grandmother's favorite food? What's the age of her grandmother? Who is your grandmother's best friend? How are we supposed to know that? But then, that was just Anika. And Anika was a queen. I could always remember that the last time I spoke to Anika was for my birthday, which was August 13th. And me and Anika spent 4 hours on the phone and talking about all kind of stuff. I remember telling Anika, you know, I felt like for some reason I think that I'm ready to have a family and, you know, have a baby and stuff. And Anika would be like, well, all you want to Brooks me now? Because if I had to be godmother to this one and I had to be godmother to our next one, we are getting all the money. But that was just typical Anika. I have a piece here from an officer at the St. Vincent Cadet Corps. He sent it, and just reading on his behalf. My dear friend Anika, the day was August 19th, 2022. I logged onto Facebook in the morning and received this sudden message from a close friend of hers that Anika was no longer with us. I went to her profile, which showed a radiant face, but followed a timeline post saying, Anika, wake up, please. We miss you so much, and you will always remain in our heart. No, I thought, it can't be. My friend was too young to die, and I called her dad, who was soaking surely in tears, and I heard him break down over the phone, only confirming my worst fears. I was preparing for work, but I couldn't move and sat staring at the wall before in my tears. It's not easy knowing someone so full of life suddenly die. Anika and I met over 10 years ago in St. Vincent, where I lived, at a Caribbean cadet camp. She was never shy nor afraid of getting her hands dirty and learning something new. As her instructor then, she was focused, disciplined, and determined. Over time, we became closer friends. Though separate miles away by water, in this friendship of over 10 years, we talked about life and work, and sometimes I gave her advice when needed. She had a great love for family, and I remember in May when her siblings were ill, she was very worried about them, even though she was recovering. Her parents were everything, and surely her special love for her nieces and nephew, as if they were her own. Everyone knew Nika was jovial and told her mind as it was. But one thing for sure, she loved her God and vividly recalled a few years ago when she told me to get baptized and not take the Lord for granted. I know she will be greatly missed by her family, friends, and coworkers. Nothing I can say here take away the pain and sorrow, but we shall surely meet again, my friend. Sleep in peace, my friend, and my God, perpetual light shine upon you. From the officer at St. Vincent Cadet Corps, Augustine Ferdinand. And now we'll have a video from the Grenada Cadet Corps. Thank you.
I know we're all wondering how could somebody so young, so vibrant and full of life be gone. I know we're wondering if anybody cares, but there is a God who cares, He is touched with the feelings of our infirmities. Right this moment, he is touched. Be comforted in God's love and in his grace. At this time, we invite Curly, who would recite a poem, and we pray the words of this poem would be able to touch your hearts. Curly, while we wait on Curly, those of you who has to perform other tributes, you can stand at the stage, at the stairs of the stage to my right.
So the name of this poem entitled Anika Amanda Stephen. Thanks, I love you too. Were the last words I heard from you. My heart broke when I heard the news. You left us hopeless with no answers or any clues. Saddest day of my life. The words struck me like a knife. She left us. She really left us. If I only knew that this was goodbye, I would have sent you off with a paragraph you deserve and elaborate on how much you were loved. Mo, a name inspired by the Three Stooges. You were the leader of our tribe, the mastermind, our partner in crime. Your face was filled with mysteries, and with every slick look you gave me, we created history. Pranking cadets was fun at camp out, waiting till they fell asleep at lights out. In we came with makeup and glue. We gave them eyebrows and mustache too. We laughed and even felt sorry. We thought about the consequences and it made us worry. In the morning, we will keep our cool, wiping our grins off to see who we can fool. Everyone would know it was us. Once the Three Stooges were on camp, mushing was a must. Because of this, we made a bond. We made lots of friends and we had lots of fun. As time passed, our friendship grew stronger. I know we all wish we could keep you here longer. They say, legends never die. So it is my hope that you are still here. We will continue to love and keep you near. My hope is in God that your soul he will keep as you close your eyes and go to sleep. Sleep in peace, my love.
Thank you, Collie. That was beautiful. That was really beautiful. Someone so young impacted the lives of so many people. We had a representative of the Grenada and St. Vincent Cadet Corps, and that beautiful tribute in pictures, absolutely beautiful. And here we have someone else attesting to the love of Anika for someone so young. That is indeed beautiful. At this time, I would like to invite others, if you would like to sing, if you would like to share a memory. Okay, so here we have someone. Let's welcome her, please.
Good afternoon to everyone. Dolly, Dolly, hear you saying, you can't call me Dolly no more, because I'm big now. These special memories of you will always bring a smile. If only we could have you back for just a little while. Then we could sit and talk again, just like we used to. You always meant so much to us, especially your mom and dad. Gone from our sight, but never from our hearts. The fact that you are no longer here with us will always cause us pain, but you are forever in our hearts until we meet again. We love you. Rest in peace, cause.
At this time, we call on Sandra Pascal, who will bless our hearts with song as a tribute to Anika and to her family. Ms. Pascal.
Miss your voice, miss your smile, everything about you, worth a while. Always wonder where you are. I hope you're with us, near or far. Many questions or answers I guess we'll never knew. But now you belong to heaven. It's empty without your smile. The truth brings us to tears. All the love you give us all these years. Always seeing you at night, when I turn off the lights and the world asleep. In my heart you always say, you'll never forget you. You'll never fade away. I always remember the times we shared together. Remember your laughter forever and ever. But now you belong to heaven. It's empty without your smile. The truth brings us to tears. All the love you give us all these years. And I wonder why you see the first I say. If I meet you one day again, and I hope that you remember my name. If I see you again. Now you belong to heaven. It's empty without your smile. The truth brings us to tears. All the love you give us. And now you belong to heaven. It's empty. The truth brings us to tears. All the love you give us all those years. All the love you give us all these years. Thank you.
The love she gave to each and every one of us for all these years. Please let that bring you comfort. I know the occasion is bitter, but it is also sweet. At this time, I'll call on representatives of the class of TAMCC 2015 to do a tribute.
Good afternoon, everybody. As I write this, tears wet my face. She was always so positive, always trying hard to keep pace. Like a candle which burns itself, taking on more than she could bear. She lit the way for others when they were in complete despair. She will always be remembered as a beacon of hope and positivity. To be remembered with deep affection in times of negativity. She is with us in spirit and always will be. Her memory will cast a shade on us like a huge leafy tree. I bid you farewell, my friend. May you roam in the gardens of heaven, smiling down upon us and all your lovely friends.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is a tribute to my soul sister and best friend, Anika Amanda Stephen. It has been hard writing these lines because I couldn't find the exact words involved in it. Somehow, it was easier to just sit and cry in the dark than to do this at last. We met Anika in college. I remember the first day we met. She was sitting alone and didn't seem to know anyone. I said to myself, how such a pretty person could be alone? Elizabeth and I decided to go over to her and introduce ourselves. And right from that moment, we clicked. I knew she would be my best friend, and I wasn't mistaken. For the next couple of years, we shared everything that two girlfriends could share. For her, I was the person she turned to when things got rough. I knew her secrets, desires, fears, silly crushes, and serious relationship problems. She was the same for me. We had no secrets, never lied to each other. We were always brutally honest and full of respect. She let me in her inner world, into her mind, and deepest corners of her soul. So did I. We then made friends with Shamak and Chad, including Elizabeth, and we became the Fantastic Five. Never will I forget them all for giving me the best years of my life. We'll always remember and cherish every moment we shared. Always stick together and became more like family. Anika was always the one to make you laugh and always was up to commit a crime. She was very brave and was always down for whatever. Anika was just another version of myself. She was kind-hearted, trustworthy, loyal, down-to-earth, fun, and loving. She was always ready to stop everything she was doing to listen and always been there through the good, the bad, and the ugly. There was never a dull moment. A whole vibe wherever she went. I always admired her strength and the way she always took the time to groom herself, always beautiful and slayed anything she fitted in. I remember back in school, Nika was always late almost every day because she made sure her hairstyle and makeup had to be on point. And guess what? She aced all her assignments and exams at the end. I remember Chad and Shamak saying to her, "Girl, even on your wedding day, you would show up late and use the kicks on her." We had the best days as friends. The greatest of all was acting a whole African movie as a presentation that we never planned, all five of us. If you were in Hospitality Arts 2013 to 2015, you would definitely remember that day of history in our journey. We've been through hell and back, and Nika was always the one to remind us that there was hope when we didn't seem to see no way. That was the kind of friend you wanted to have around you when pressure was upon us. Always was willing to help with assignments when we struggled. Chad can testify to that. The relationship advisor, Betty and Shama, can testify to that. Nika was like a drug that would make me feel better whenever I was down or didn't feel as myself. And that's why I love her. What hurt me the most was how excited she was to meet her unborn god baby. After revealing the news of the gender, last thing I remembered was how happy she was. Nika promised to be there for both of us, and that really broke my heart now that she is no longer here in flesh. That day I got the call that my best friend was hospitalized and later pronounced dead. It is a memory that I cannot erase from my mind, neither from my heart. Although I told her lots of time that I love her dearly, I would give anything to turn back time and tell her that I love her one last time. To tell her that without her, my life is not complete and that she is a very important part of it. People say that time heals all wounds, but today I can tell you that's not true. Till today, I feel the same pain in my heart that I felt on August 19, 2022. Nika, you left an empty place in my heart, a place that nobody can fill. I thank you for those years of friendship that you gave me. Thank you for everything you did for us. I will always remember your smiling, beautiful face. Your spirit is now free, even though you won't really be gone because you will live inside us. I promise to honor you in all the moments ahead that you had to be a part of. And to your god baby, I promise to tell him about Auntie Nika. Even though I will miss you, I'll think about you every day. I still write in your inbox since you departed. That's how much I long for you. You will always be my best friend, and we love you forever. Farewell. Shamak.
We will now have a song by Shamak, Someone Like You.
So this one is for Nika. So if you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, so there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees, and if you lend a voice who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give shine to the ones who've lost the way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, And when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. Nika, you out there, so keep doing what you do. But there's a place out there for people like you. Nika, we love you. We love you.
Indeed, it is a sad time, and tributes like these really would cause one to just really cry and sorrow. But in that sorrow, I want us to remember that God cares. You have people all around you who care. At this time, I'd like to invite Pastor Rodriguez, who represents the Universal Church, to share a short tribute with us.
Good afternoon, everyone. I just would like to share a small memory about the importance of praying. I know that many of you here have been always exercising the power of prayer and had the opportunity to meet Anika minutes before her pass in the ICU. That is the reason why I came up here to share this memory with every one of you. And as I know the family, and I have noticed that how deeply they have been praying for the entire family circle. And one of the things that really draw my attention about the power of prayer is that in the moment that I enter in the ICU, when we are praying inside of the ICU, I could notice the tear rolling down her eye, on the corner of her eye. And right there I noticed that she was accepting wholeheartedly the prayer in the last seconds of her pass. So what does it mean? It means that every one of you that pray for family, for loved ones, never goes blank. I wanted to tell you that there is no loss when you put your faith in Christ. There is no loss when you put your faith in God and you relate your needs before Him. The Word of God says that whatever you ask, believing that you receive, it's going to be done. It seems to be a loss in the sight of man, but I can testify without a shadow of doubt that there is no loss to hear. This is what I'd like to share. God bless.
What a very timely message on the power of prayer. I would like to encourage everyone to pray for the family. They need as much prayers as they can get at this time. It is not a very easy thing they are going through, as we can all see. Mr. John Amade would now do a tribute. Mr. John Amade.
beautiful life. Just reflecting on the lyrics of that song, on Christ, the solid rock I stand, all other rock is sinking sand. Family, I would like to invite you to rest on the Lord. Depend on Him. This is a really hard time. But with the help of God, and it's only with the help of God, without Him, nothing is possible. Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Church, I'd like to say to you, we are heading into the final two tributes. The time for the tribute section has already elapsed. So at this time, I'd invite Amy Celestine to the microphone. Amy Celestine. Okay, while we wait on Amy, I'd like to invite Winnie to be prepared. So you'll come after Amy, Winnie.
Tell me, what does it look like in heaven? Is it peaceful? Is it free like they say? Does the sun shine bright forever? Have your fears and your pain gone away? Here on earth, it feels like everything good is missing, like since you left. And here on earth, everything's different. There's an emptiness. Oh, I hope you dancing in the sky, and I hope you're singing in the angels' choir, and I hope the angels know what they have. I bet it's so nice up in heaven since you arrived. So tell me, what do you do up in heaven? Are your days filled with love and light? Is there music? Is there art and adventure? Tell me, are you happy? Are you more alive? 'Cause here on earth it feels like everything good is missing since she left. And here on earth everything's different. There's an emptiness. Oh, I hope you dancing in the sky, and I hope you're singing in the angel's choir, and I hope the angels know what they have. I bet it's
So could two members of the family help me, please? Thank you. We know this is a really difficult time.
We know everyone wants to do a tribute, no matter how hard it is, so we understand what's happening here. It's not easy. If we have somebody who is versed in first aid, can you meet us backstage, please? The people standing backstage, could you make room, please? Thank you. She's going to be okay. I know you're worried. She's going to be okay. We have a few people versed in first aid who is going to assist her. All right, and we understand the words or the lyrics in that song, very inquiring. She's wondering what Anika is doing. She's wondering. There are so many questions, especially with sudden death, and it really does tear the heart. It really, really does. So at this time, while Amy is being tended to, we'll invite Winnie to do the final tribute. Winnie?
Good afternoon, everyone. Today I stand here on the last viewing of my cousin. It's unbelievable, it's speechless. I just can't hold it in. I know she will be surely missed by a lot of people who know her, who was close to her, but I know she's in a better place with the Father above.
It's so hard to lose the one you love, to finally have to say goodbye. You try to be strong, but the pain keeps holding on, and all that you can do is cry. Deep within your heart, you know it's time to move on. When the fairy tale that you once knew is gone. When the last teardrops fall, I'll still be holding on to all of our memories. And all of what used to be. When the last teardrop falls, I will stand tall and know that you're here with me. In my heart, when the last teardrop falls. So now I'm alone, and life keeps moving on, but my destination's still unknown. Will there be a time when I fall in love again, when I was meant to walk the streets alone? If there was just one wish I could be granted here today, it would be to have you right here by my side. When the last teardrop falls, still be holding on to all of our memories. In all of what it used to be. When the last teardrop falls, I will stand tall and know that you're here with me. In my heart, when the last teardrop falls. Now it's time for me to find my happiness. But
so as we end the tribute section, I invite Miss Fiona Whiteman to the podium to begin the service. Miss Whiteman. Good afternoon once again. We're going to go straight into the service, and I'm going to call Minister Enid Joseph as she comes to do the opening prayer.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Could you all join us standing as we reverence our Heavenly Father?
Bless the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Eternal and gracious God, we bless you. We honor you. We adore you this evening, Lord. We acknowledge you. We acknowledge you, for you are far above principalities, powers, and spiritual wickedness in high places, in the name of Jesus. Lord, your word says, this is a day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, whether in health, whether in sickness, whether in debt. Lord, we rejoice, for this is your word. You said also, oh God, give your thanks. For this is your will, and we thank you this hour, O God. Mighty God, there are many hearts that are sorrowful, hurting, sad this evening. But Lord, I pray that you will comfort, you will heal, you will deliver, O God, every hurting heart this evening. Let them know, O God, there is one, and his name is Jesus. A friend that sticketh closer than a brother, a sister, a mother, and a father. His name is Jesus. He cares. He cares. He alone cares this evening. Hallelujah. My God, we bless you. Oh God, you promise you will never leave us, not forsake us, but you will be with us to the end. Oh Lord, your promises are yea and amen. And so we thank you this evening. Oh God, as a servant of God, prepare, oh God, to preach your word. Mighty God, we know that you said your word will not return void, but it'll prosper and accomplish to the things in where it is sent to this evening. Oh God, we know, oh God, that a preacher is not preaching to the dead. Your word says that the dead knows nothing, but the living know that they will die. And so, oh God, I pray this evening that all those men, women, boy, and girl that doesn't know you as Lord and Savior, oh God, I pray that they surrender their hearts to you. Oh God, I pray, oh God, that they take heed and put their house in order before it's too late, because death is no respecter of person. Death is a must. And so, God, I pray, oh God, for all of those who don't know you, oh God, to surrender all to you in the mighty name of Christ Jesus of Nazareth. Lord, we give you thanks this hour. Lord, we give you praise. We give you glory, for you alone, Lord, know all about it. You are the all-knowing God. You are the all-powerful God. You are the omnipotent God. You are the omnipresent God. And so, Lord, you say in everything, give you thanks. And so we thank you this evening. Even in death, Lord, we thank you. My God, remind us that this world is not our own. Lord, remind us this evening that we are just passenger, and help us, oh God, to prepare, oh God, to meet our maker. Help us to prepare, Lord, to meet our maker. Lord, for you are a God of chances. You are a God of love. Hallelujah. And so God, take charge and take control. I thank you that your word will not fall on deaf ears this evening, but it will pierce hearts this evening. It will surrender hearts this evening. In Jesus' mighty name we ask, amen and amen.
Amen, amen. Somebody say hallelujah. Glory to God. Remain standing as we're going to call the person to do the scripture reading. Hallelujah. I'm going to read 1 Corinthians, since no one is coming. I'm going to read from 1 Corinthians 15. I'm going to read from 53 to 58. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Amen. You may have your seats. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And now we're going to go straight into worship. Hallelujah. Are you ready to worship God? Are you ready to give him praise? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We now call Sister Shirley, and she's going to lead us in worship.
Hallelujah. We bless the name of Jesus. We bless the name of Jesus in this place today. In all your grieving, you have to know that he can give you strength. He can comfort you. So even as we worship the Lord, I invite you to stand. And we're just going to give the Lord what is due unto him, because we depend on him for strength. This strength that we need, we cannot do it without him. Hallelujah, Jesus. Father, we worship your name, oh God. Hallelujah, Jesus. He's our strength. Strength like no other, Lord. We bless your name. We bless your name. We bless your name in this place today, oh God. Comfort the grieving hearts, oh God. Comfort the family and the friends, oh God. Father, you know, you know, you know, you know. You are my strength.
Strength like no other.
Come on, strength like no other. If you can stand, you can.
Strength.
How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God, and all who see how great.
Come on, sing with me.
How great,
how great is our God.
Our God.
Our God.
Oh, great.
Father, you are great.
Our
Hallelujah. As we do this final song, I will be still and know you are God. I know there are a lot of questions in your mind as to why and how come and why not somebody else, but God knows. And the only thing that we can pray and ask him is to teach us to be still and know that he knows what he's doing and know that he is our God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Teach us to be still, oh God. If you're still sitting, I invite you to stand. Because the presence of the Lord is here, whether you think it's a funeral or not. The presence of the Lord is here and he wants to work in your life. You can leave this building and you don't have to return home. We don't know, but what you do know that you have the opportunity to ask the Lord to teach you to be still and know that he is God in your life today. Hallelujah. Life is short. Death is sure. Sin is the cause, but Jesus is the cure today. And even as we wait for him to be still in our lives, you have that opportunity today to not leave here the same that you came in. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you for your presence, oh God. Hide me now under oceans rise and thunders roar.
shout hallelujah. Somebody give him praise. Hallelujah. We are here to have church, somebody. Our God is alive and he sits on the throne. Hallelujah. He is more than able to keep that concern, somebody. Hallelujah. It's okay to weep and to mourn. But we know that we have a maker and there is a day that is coming that we will see him face to face. Glory to God. You may have your seats in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Before we call our preacher, Pastor Ian Crow, we have a special by Miss Yolanda Ross. Are you ready? Raise of hand. Hallelujah. Okay. Okay, so we're going to call Pastor Ian Crow as he comes. Oh, sorry, my bad. I just got excited for a moment there. Amen, glory to God. We're going to call Shirley-Ann Frank, and she's going to do the eulogy at this moment.
A pleasant good afternoon to everyone. My name is Chenille Danielle Frederick and not Shirley Ann Frank. I am Anika's past teacher at the Boca Secondary School. I extend my deepest condolences to her family and friends. I ask God's presence and comfort as we bid her farewell. Let us trust and believe in the promises of God. We are blessed to have known Anika at the Boca Secondary School, and she will be remembered as an exemplary student. It is extremely difficult to stand here today to read the eulogy for our beloved Anika, affectionately called Nika, and Nike to her loved ones. Anika Stephen was born on October 30th, 1996. She was the daughter of Cynthia and Clifford Duncan. She was the baby to her siblings, Ron, Mike, Nevron, Kimmy, and Rhonda. She attended Patricia's private primary school, then the Beaulieu New Testament School. In 2008, she sat the common entrance examination and successfully passed. Anika attended the Boca Secondary School from 2008 to 2013, where she excelled academically. She actively participated in extracurricular activities. She was particularly excited about cheerleading whenever sports came around. She was actively involved in the cadet corps. In fact, she was the first female sergeant of the Boca Secondary School. She represented the Grenada Cadet Corps in St. Vincent and Dominica. Anika successfully graduated from the Boca Secondary School and received many awards for her outstanding work. Her educational journey did not stop there. She then went on to the T.A. Marischal Community College, where she pursued an associate degree in hospitality studies. After she completed college, she went on to work at Grooms Beach and Villa, Duty Free Caribbean, and then Flo, where she worked until she transitioned. Anika was a brave, intelligent, talented, and kind-hearted individual. She loved fashion and pageantry. She participated in the Northeast Queen Show as a teenager, where she performed exceptionally well. In her free time, she enjoyed doing makeup and designing nails. Every time she learned a new skill, she would practice on her nieces, Jadel, Amy, Chelsea, and many others. She made it her duty to do makeup for their birthday, graduation ball, career day, and other special events. They could have depended on Auntie Nika to also teach them the skills that she knew. Furthermore, Nika was very supportive of her nieces and nephews. She assisted them with their homework and SBAs. She purchased a laptop to ensure they had a device to complete their assignments and SBAs. She encouraged them to perform well and accompanied them many times to collect their report books. Anika supported her family financially, and she ensured that they were never without, even if she had to sacrifice. No matter what the situation was, she was willing to provide support. She loved her family and would sacrifice anything to make sure they were all happy. Anika was a beautiful and cheerful young lady. She loved life. She was a role model for many individuals. She formed excellent bonds with her family members, friends, and co-workers. She loved food and enjoyed dancing. She enjoyed the company of her siblings, and she created wonderful memories that would last a lifetime before her sudden passing. She was a hard worker, and she was determined to excel even further. Prior to her death, she had plans of joining the Royal Grenada Police Force. She sat the exam and received the news that she successfully passed the exam the Monday before she died. Today is indeed a sad day for us all. Our hearts are breaking. Today we trust in God for comfort and strength as you depart this life, Anika. You are our rock. God, we thank you for the life of Anika Stephen. We thank you for the 25 beautiful years Anika spent on earth. Anika, your memories would live on in our hearts forever. We love you. Rest in eternal peace.
Hallelujah. It's such a joy to hear all the wonderful things when someone pass. You know, and sometimes I wonder, why do we have to wait until to tell our loved ones how much we appreciate them, how much they are impacting lives. But we thank God that we are here to hear what she has done, and she has impacted many lives. And we want to leave a legacy. But when we do all that we do, we want to do it as unto the glory of God. It's He that have us here. We woke up this morning, we didn't just get up on our own. He lent us the breath another day. So we have to be grateful. We don't know what the next minute holds. Only God knows. Anika, already on her journey, we are here. What are we going to do? Are we going to make our calling and election sure? Or Pastor Ian Crow going to come and bring us the word? And we're going to sing, "It Is Well." Amen. Just join us standing. Just worship God. Hallelujah. In the beauty of holiness. When you worship Him, healing comes. Deliverance comes. Peace. Breakthroughs come in the midst of worship. Hallelujah.
When peace like a river attendeth my ways, when sorrows like seas below As we go.
Hallelujah. I think the question is whether it is well with you or you are trying to make it well. The only person that can fix your life today is Jesus Christ. He is the answer for your problems. He's the answer to your needs. And he's the answer for your eternal salvation. Good afternoon to everyone. I would like to take this opportunity to extend and express my condolences to the Berry family, the Stephen family. I know this moment is a very sad and grievous moment. It is not easy to lose one that you love dear, especially when they were not sick, lying in bed, and the doctor would have said to you that they're going to die. Strong, healthy, young, beautiful, attractive young lady just up and passed. This tells us, ladies and gentlemen, that death is no respect of persons. And that no one can escape death because there is always an appointed moment. With everyone that is sitting here today, death has an appointment with you. And you can do what you want. And if you're not, then he said, okay, I will come back again when you're ready. No, sir. The Bible said it is appointed unto man once to die. That is a must. But the question is, if death comes, are you ready? Are you prepared? Is your heart right with God? And I believe many of you are left today to answer this question. I want to read to you this afternoon, and I try to be as brief as possible because time is already fast. A certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that befalleth me. And he divided unto them his living. And not many days after, the youngest son gathered together all and took his journey into a far country. There he wasted his substance with righteous living. Amen. Let me just pay respect to the minister. I didn't realize it was him sitting there. Amen. Let us put our hands together for this. Amen. Ron Redhead. Praise God. It's a pleasure having you, sir. Hallelujah. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in the land and began to be in want. And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and there he sent him into the fields to feed swines. And he would have faint having his belly filled with husks, that the swine did eat it, and no man give it unto him. And when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servant of my father, bread enough to spare, and I perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father and will say unto him, Father, I have sinned again. Father, we thank you for your word today. We give you praise, glory, and honor, Lord. We thank you for the opportunity given to us that we can come today, Lord, to declare the unsearchable riches of your word to those who are here to listen. We take authority over the plans and powers of the enemy. We bring every demon of power to subjection. We come against every, oh God, opposing spirit. And every spirit that rise, oh God, Lord God, to bring objection to your word. We stop the plans of the enemy and we declare release in the realm of the atmosphere. Lord, touch the hearts of your people. Give them receptive hearts that they will receive from you and from your word today. In Jesus' mighty name, and everybody say, I want to speak to you for a brief moment on the subject, it is time to come to yourself. It is time to come to yourself. And I believe, ladies and gentlemen, that many of you that are here this evening, you came with one, amen, intention, and that is to sympathize with the bereaved family on the loss of their loved one. But we know Anika is lying in the coffin. She's not here. Her body is here. Her spirit already went back to the Maker. It is so sad, however, to stand here knowing when this young lady was a baby, I was responsible for dedicating her and offering up to God. I have done so many dedications that I have forgotten. As a matter of fact, the parents had to remind me, Pastor, you are the one that lifted up Anika when she was a baby. And today, I am given the privilege to be the one to bury her. What a sad moment. But today, however, Anika would have lived her life. She would have lived her life, I believe, to the best of her ability, to how she knew how to live it. And so because of the way that she chose to live her life, she would have made preparation, I believe, to meet her Maker. But the question is, what about you? Are you prepared to meet your Maker? If you were in the place of Anika, were you ready to meet God? Oh, you're still living your life because, Pastor, I am young, I am vibrant, amen, I'm energetic, and I still have my future ahead of me. I cannot give no heed or pay no heed to this church life. I have my life to live. Let me live it to the best of my ability. That's all right. I respect that. Even God respects your wishes. And that's why it's important that we understand that after death we don't blame God for where we open our eyes after we would have passed from this death, from this life, amen, to another life. The Bible declared there was a young man who lived, amen, I believe he would have grown up into a home that was respectable. A home that would have taught him, amen, the moral principles of life. That would have taught him the way of salvation. I believe his father and mother would have brought him up in the way of salvation. But somehow, amen, that young man would have grown and came to the age of accountability and and experience life and what life is all about. So he came to his father and said to his father, Father, give me what is mine. I want to go out and enjoy life. I want to go out and have pleasure. I want to go out and even live up my life. I want to do my thing. I am young. I have my future ahead of me. I need a break. I have no time now for this Christian life that you brought me up in. Daddy, I want to live my life. And I believe many of you that are sitting here today may have, amen, they be in this condition where you would have decided that you want to live. You want to do what you want. But I'm here to declare for you, life does not begin until you know Jesus as your Lord and Savior. A lot of persons and people believe that life begins when they, amen, enjoy pleasure. But life only begins when we get to know Jesus as our Lord and Savior. I thought I had life until at the age of 16 I gave my life to Jesus. Then I realized and finally found out that living for God is the best thing that anyone can do. And I'm here to declare to you, amen, if you're really looking for life, the best life that you can live is the life for Jesus Christ. The life, amen, in Jesus Christ has benefits. The life in Jesus Christ has profits. Amen. The life in Jesus Christ, amen, there's an eternal hope. But this young man, however, decided that he wants to live. He wants to live, amen, in the world. He wants to enjoy life. And so the Bible said, amen, as a good father will, he would have called his son and enlightened him, son, what you want to do. The places you want to go, the things you want to do is not what God expects of you. It is not the best way out. And I believe daddy would have admonished his son and counseled his son, amen, and entreat his son not to go out there, because out there only have death. Amen. Out there, amen, there's no good thing out there. But children, as usual, always want to experience what life is about. So sad that sometimes we try to experience it and we never had the opportunity to return. We go, we live, and we die without having to return to God. And you know what happens in a moment like this? It's sadness. Because if you die without Christ, hell is your portion. I don't care who tell you that if you die, they can pray you out from hell. Tell that person they just started, amen, realize that what they're saying to you is a lie from the pit of hell. The Bible says that it is appointed unto man once to die, but after death comes the judgment. No man could pray you out of hell. Not even God can pray you out of hell. You know why? Because God has given us an opportunity, and that opportunity is, he said, behold, I place before you death and life, choose. And when you make your choice by choosing, amen, death, that will be your consequences. That will be the final destiny. Are you there? But when you choose life, ladies and gentlemen, you have chosen the right path. However, the Bible said that the father would have given the young one his inheritance. He collect all that he could have received from daddy. And the Bible said the next day he took his journey into a far country. In other words, I ain't staying in Grenada no more. A lot of people know me as a Christian growing up, so I want to go where nobody know me, where I can live my life, where I can do my thing. and nobody knows me, but I'm here to tell you wherever you go, God is. Amen. You can't run from God. You can run from people, but you can't run from God. And that's why it's a good thing to serve God and be bold in serving God. Don't let nobody tell you serving God, amen, is not good. Amen. Serving God is the best thing that anyone can do. And so that young man took his journey into a far country. And the Bible said there he wasted his substance. Yes, sir, with righteous living. My God, he live up. He live him in vulgarity. Amen. He live a life of wickedness. He live a life, amen, that the glory to God he never experienced before. Women of all types. Yes, sir. He continued to live the life, glory to God, that he wanted to live. But hear me, sir. Amen. The Bible said the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. No matter how you live, there is still hope in God. That young man live up his life. The Bible says he wastes his substance with righteous living. You know, when you have money, you have friends. And so he would have left home, I believe, with a lot of money in his pocket, because daddy would have divided, amen, their living and give to him. And so he would have left home in fine style. Amen. Looking good. Are you there? Amen. Well groomed. Amen. But glory to God. And he had enough cash in his pocket that when he entered the bar, everybody said, there's a new dude in town. There's a new guy in town. And he's spending money wild. And the young ladies, you know, excuse me, young ladies, but they heard about the young dude in town. And everybody want to have a part. Are you there? And the guy feel he was it, because everybody flocking him. Let me tell you something. I've learned in life that money answered all things. And amen, when you have money, you have friends. But after everything is over, they forgot who you are. And he would have lived. He would have spent from bar to bar, from nightclub to nightclub, night after night. Hello, women of different species, women of all kind. Yes, he was enjoying life. Are you here today? He was enjoying life and everybody keep flocking him. But there came a time, the Bible said, there arose a famine. Yes, sir. You see, things may not always be gloomy. There are times you're going to hit rock bottom, and that is when you need God. You see, a lot of times when people are at their peak and at the top of their glory, they don't need God. Amen. But when the doctor said to you have the last moment to live, and there is nothing we can do for you, call the pastor, call the preacher, we need prayer. Let me tell you something. God ain't no Nancy story. God ain't no Mika Mika. God is God. He is holy, and God must not be taken for granted. It's either you need him now or never. We don't use God when the doctor said to us, it's over. I've had some moments like these. When people will call you, they live their life recklessly. Never made a decision to serve God. And they're on their dying bed. And they want you to come pray for them, because they want to go to heaven. Hello. Let me surprise you for a moment. You know why I love God? Because God knows all things. He don't guess. He knows very much that you're using him conveniently, because you're going to die. And if you are going to live, you ain't going to serve him. So let me have a little excuse, a little surprise for you this evening. Persons like this ain't going to heaven, because you're using God conveniently, and God is not a convenient God. God said in his word in Ecclesiastes chapter 12 and verse 1, remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth, while the evil days come not, nor the year draw nigh, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in you, when you have nothing in you, amen, when all your youth, amen, is exhausted, when everything, glory to God, you have used it up, now you're ready for God. Hear me, sir, remember him now, while you're alive, while you yet have strength. Now is the time for you to give God your life so he can use you for his glory. The young man faced a crisis in his life where everything that he had finished. Can you imagine? All the money, the credit card, huh? No more money on the account. The credit card can't work no more. Rejected, when they push it in the machine, is rejected. Hello, now he is in want. I believe in those moments, he'll have tried to get to his friends, who he made during the time, amen, of his spending. But when he knocked on the first door, somebody said, I don't know you, I can't remember, who are you again? And he knocked on the second door, and the person said, I don't know you. Where are all the nice ladies? They don't know you. They move on to somebody else who have more to offer them. That is what friends does to you, ladies and gentlemen. And the Bible said, finally, he joined himself with a citizen of that country. And you see what's happening? Look what happened. When sin finished with you, you're no good. You are facing embarrassment. You are facing rejection. You are facing, amen, criticism. You are facing, praise God, moments where you don't know what to do. But you know what I thank God for? And I'm saying to you, ladies and gentlemen, mothers and fathers, continue to instill good values in your children. And when you do that, they will always remember what you have instilled in them, even when they reach and face crisis in their lives. The Bible said the citizens of that country send him into the field to feed swines. You know what swine is, right? Pig. And so, the pig pen was his place of residence. That's where he lived. From a palace to a pig pen. That's what sin does to everyone that is sitting here. You think sin nice? It may appear to be nice. But after it, what happens? Huh? The Bible says, what shall it profit a man if he shall gain this whole world and lose his soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? What it is that you and I can give to God at the day of judgment and say, God, give me a pass now. They normally have all different shows in this place here. And I believe when you enter the door, you may see a friend and you may say to the friend, give me a pass now, man. And the friend might say, oh, give me a moment, I'll get a slip in a while. You know what I'm saying? But in heaven, on the day of judgment, ain't no pass. Ain't no pass. If you're not sealed and stamped with the blood of Jesus, you are lost. I don't care what anybody tell you. Pastor, I don't believe there is hell. God is too loving to cast people in hell. That is so sure and it's so true. God is too loving to send people in hell. You put yourself in hell because you make the decision, not God. You decide that you wanted to go to hell because on earth you decided I didn't want to serve God anyway. You know why? These church people and them too hypocrite. These church people and them, they're playing holy. Hear me, sir. Let me tell you something. The only thing that is done and will last forever is serving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. The Bible said that the young man was sent into the field to feed swines. And what happened? The scripture says that he ate from the pig food. Can you imagine? He ate the pig food, else he would have fainted. Hello? So he robbed the pig from his meal. Hello? All because he rejected his father's counsel. He rejected his father's advice and decided to do what he wants. Every sin has its consequences. Every action that we would have taken in life has its consequences. Are you hearing me, church? But the Bible said him being in the pig pen would have fainted. He came to his senses. It's a good thing that even when you're at the moment, glory to God, and things seems gloomy and things seems bad, that you can think again. You can once again think that what daddy would have taught me, I still have an opportunity to call on God. And this is what I'm here to declare to you this afternoon. You still have an opportunity to call on God. He said, if you call on me, I will answer and I will show you great and mighty things that you know not. If you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart the Lord Jesus, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believe and with the mouth confess is made unto salvation. If you confess your sins, he is faithful and just to forgive you and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. So you mean, preacher, and regardless to what I've done in life, God still will forgive me? Oh yeah. Oh yeah. That's why the Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For verse 17 says, for God sent his son not into this world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. You listen to the quotation? The world through him might be saved, which means that that decision of being saved is yours. If you make that choice, you can be saved. And that's why the Bible says might be, because there are a lot of people who will not be saved. They go to church Sunday after Sunday. Amen. They do all kind of Mickey Mouse thing Sunday after Sunday. And amen, Sunday night they're in the party hall. Let me tell you something. God is a just God. God is a holy God. God is a righteous God. And God does not have pleasure in the things of the world. He said, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. For if any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world is the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the pride of life. And these things is not of the Father, but of the world. And if you go back to your scripture, 1 John 2:15 and 16, that's what I just quote. The word world there symbolizes the devil. So the Bible said, it is not of the Father, but of the world. So the pleasures thereof is of the devil. And any person that walk in the pleasures of this world cannot please God, will not be able to please God. And because they can't please God, any man that is in the flesh is of the devil. Amen. Except you be led of the Spirit, glory to God, the Bible says, for as many as are led by the Spirit, they are sons of God. Glory to God. And so, if you allow yourself to be led by God, only then you can be called children of God. Hold on, preacher. I can challenge you on that. We all are God's children. No. We all are God's creation. We only become God's children when the Bible says, to as many as receive him, to them give he the power to be called sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. So you only become a child of God when you accept Jesus as your Savior. How then? Because we have sold out, amen, our amen inheritance, our rightful position because of sin. The Bible says sin has bring division within you and God. Huh? That's what the word of God says. God is, it's not death. Huh? Neither his eyes heavy. But our sins have separated us from God. But he said, come now, let us reason together, said the Lord. He said, though your sin be as scarlet, they shall be as wool. Though it be red as crimson, it shall be made white as snow. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is that flow that makes me white as snow. There's not a fount I know but the blood of Jesus. You want to be saved? Come to the cross of Jesus Christ. Amen. Can offer you, amen, salvation, and you can be able, amen, to rightly find your way out in Jesus Christ. So the Bible says, as we come to close, the young man said, so many hired servant of my father, and bread enough to spare, and I hunger here. He said, I will arise, and I will go back to my father, and I will say to him, Father, forgive me, for I have sinned against heaven and against thee, and I'm no more worthy to be called thy son. Now listen to it, which means he was a son, but he backslid. He went back on God. Hello. But the Bible said, the father said to him and to his servant, glory to God, go, get me a ring, a shoes, hello, which means God is about to remarry him again. I'm here to declare to you this afternoon, God wants to remarry you. Amen. Sin has brought division within you and your God. But through the death of one man, all can be made righteous. Through the righteousness of Christ Jesus, you and I can be made righteous. How can this happen? The Bible said, amen, that if we, amen, they that call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Hallelujah. All we need to do is call upon him. Call on him and say, Lord, I repent. Lord, I am sorry. Lord, I've sinned against you. Hear me, sir. It doesn't matter where you are, who you are. God loves you anywhere, and he wants to set you free. And so an invitation is extended. Come unto me, all he that are labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Jesus wants to give you rest. Preacher, you mean he really will forgive me? Yes. Your neighbor may say you will never be good. Nothing good is going to come out of you. But God is still looking at you and say, my son, I love you. And I want to make something good out of you. I want to turn you wrong. Amen. And to transform your life. And to give you a new beginning. All you need to do is acknowledge me in your life. Open your heart unto me. Hear me, sir. And Jesus Christ says, I will come in. And I will sup with you, and you with me, and you will be my son, and I shall be your father. If you are willing today to come to yourself and to your senses and say, preacher, I am being a church goer for years. But hear me, I realize it's not being a church goer, it's having a relationship with Jesus. And having a relationship with Jesus means that you will be subject to his dictates. And whatever he said to you, you're going to do. In other words, he will lead and you will follow. And so if you desire to subject yourself to the dictates of Almighty God, he's going to transform your life, he's going to set you free, and he's going to give you a purpose for living. All you need to do is to come to yourself and say, I am a sinner and I need a savior. You must acknowledge. And this is what happened. The young man, first of all, came to his senses. Secondly, he acknowledged that he was a sinner. Thirdly, he confessed his sins. Amen. And fourthly, he asked Jesus to come in to his heart. What about you this afternoon? Are you going to walk away and continue to live the way you have been living for years? Or you'll want to try this better way that I'm talking about? I can guarantee you that if you surrender your life to Jesus, you will never regret it. I can guarantee you that the best way out is to serve Jesus. And there is always benefits in serving God. Is there anyone here this afternoon that would say, preacher, I came to Anika funeral, but this could be a moment for me to change my life. For me to make a decision to follow Jesus. Would you pray for me this afternoon? I need Jesus. I need to turn my life around. I need to follow the Lord Jesus. Is there anyone that will indicate by the raising of the hand and say, preacher, I need Jesus today. I want to serve God. Amen. No matter who might be sitting next to you, you need to make the decision. Remember, if you choose him today, he will not be ashamed to own you before his father. If you're afraid to own him before men, he will also be ashamed to own you before his father. And here you are. You're saying, I need Jesus. Would you pray for me? Lift your hand. I'm going to pray for you today because you need Jesus. Is there anyone today? Thank you for that hand. Is there anyone, amen, today that needs Jesus? Amen. Lift your hand. Thank you for that hand over there. Amen. Thank you for that hand. Thank you for that hand. Anybody else? Come on, lift your hands. Let people see, man. Amen. Thank you for that hand. Amen. Anybody else? Thank you for that hand. Anybody else today? Thank you for those hands across there. Is there anybody else that needs Jesus? Amen. This is your moment to make a turning point in your life. Don't walk away without meeting Jesus. Jesus, because he's given you an opportunity. Thank you for that hand in the back. Anybody else that needs Jesus? Anybody else today? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Wherever you are in the audience, stand to your feet. You indicated that you need Jesus. Stand up. Amen. Stand up. Don't be ashamed. Amen. Stand up. Don't be ashamed. I need Jesus. All those who lift their hands, stand up. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Stand up. You lift up your hands. Stand up. Amen. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. There's nothing to be ashamed about. You know what you should be ashamed about, young ladies and young women, young men, is walking the street naked with your body exposed. That is what you need to be ashamed of. But some of you are not ashamed of it. You're walking bold. But in serving God, you're ashamed. I don't want nobody to see us serving God. But you're walking the street naked, amen, exposing your privacy. Something that you should cherish is what you're exposing. And now it's time for you to make a decision to follow Christ. You're ashamed. You're ashamed to let people see you. You're lifting your hands or standing. Huh? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now, those of you who are standing that indicate that you need Jesus, I want you to say this prayer after me. I want you to mean it in your heart. I want you to mean it from your heart. Amen. Say it from your heart, because the Bible says, from the heart, amen, the mouth speaketh. Hallelujah. So you say this after me. Lord Jesus, I come to you today in the precious name of Jesus Christ. I have heard your word and I believe it. Come on, I want to hear. I believe it. I realize, Lord, that your word declares that if I believe in my heart and confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus, I shall be saved. And so, Lord, I publicly declare today that I am a sinner and I need a Savior. And you are the only one that can save me. So I ask you to forgive me and to cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Give me a purpose for living today. Help me from this moment on to serve you for the rest of my life. And I decided with my heart that I will continue to allow you to be Lord of my life from this day on and forevermore. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Come on, say thank you, Lord, for saving me. Thank you, Lord, for setting me free. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. You know something? You can sit. Thank you for indicating by the raising of your hands. And I'm so glad we have the service in Spice Basket, because this is a place that always have shows and parties. And I sure if you come in here and never hear anybody dead. Everybody make it nice, especially when their favorite calypsonian singing. As a matter of fact, they come out in the crowd and dancing and whining. Hello? Huh? But to dance and whine for Jesus, we don't want nobody to see that. Something that can give you eternal life, you're afraid to make a decision. Come on, who woke you up this morning? Thank you. Who gave you the breath that you're breathing? Thank you. Who put you to bed tonight? Who causing you to walk out of this place and go down without falling in the street and dying? That's why you should give him praise. Because he deserves it, not them calypsonian. You're giving them more praise than God. Hello? He is the one that placed the breath of life in us. So we have the right to give him praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So before we move on, we want the family to just come forward. We want to pray for them. And then we're going to let you loose as we go down to the cemetery. Okay, so you can't say the preacher was too long today. I ain't make an hour. Hello? I just checking my time. I ain't make an hour. So you can't say the preacher was too long. See? Big family, Stephen's family. Huh? Big family. And if this whole family decide, I want Jesus, you're not a place to put him. Hello? Huh? But I trust God that Anika's death will be a wake-up call for some of you who are sitting here. Hello? She didn't die in vain, you know. Her death should bring you to Christ. Her death should cause you to think. Because if you would have told Anika, on whatever day she died, you'd have died on her. She'd have said, no, I rebuke that. Trust me, she would have rebuked it because she don't want to die. Nobody wants to die. It's not something that we want. But the thing about it, we can't stop it when it comes. Sometimes it comes and it leaves a lot of grief, as I've been hearing somebody crying all year round, Anika, you leave us lonely, or whatever the term was. Of course, because she was dear to a lot of you. She was precious to a lot of you. I've listened, amen, to many, amen, tributes. How dear she was to many lives that she would have came in contact with. Hear me. You should be one of them that Anika would have left a stigma that you should say, look, I want to make sure that if death should come to me tomorrow, I'm ready to meet God. Hello, family, hello. And not only that, but the family should come together. The family should always knit together. Let this death even bring the family closer together. Not division, not separation. No, death should cause us to come closer. And I trust God that this passing of our loved one will bring the family closer than ever before. My heart goes out to you, family. My heart goes out because I don't know what it is to lose a young person like this. I know what it is to lose somebody in my life that was dear to me. But when they're young, so I believe it brings more pressure. It brings more pain. So I cannot put myself in a position and say, I know how you feel. No, I don't know how you feel. I don't know. And so it's always good to cry and bawl on the place for yourself. Because that helped ease the pain. It helped soothe the pain. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And so we want to pray. Is there any pastors in the midst? I think all these pastors, I guess in there. Come, pastor, come. Pastor, come here. Oh, Pastor King, are you? Ah, Pastor King, come, come. Oh, glory to God. I didn't even realize Pastor King sitting there. I saw the person there. I didn't realize it was Pastor King. Amen. Yes, amen. Sorry. Hallelujah. It seems like I need to get a new glasses. Yeah, I didn't make all the pastors and bishop. Come up here with me, pastors. Amen. Yes. Hallelujah. My apology. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And so, amen, Bishop King is in the house with us. Amen. We thank God for him. Praise God. So he's going to do the mass prayer over the entire family for us. Amen. As God console and, amen, continue to keep this family together. Amen. In the moment of the loss. So Bishop King will do the honors.
Thank you, Pastor Crow. Let me extend my personal condolences to you, the family members, during this time of bereavement. May the Lord comfort and may the Lord strengthen you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, we pause today and we just want to thank you. We want to thank you for life that you have given to us. We also want to thank you for this young lady that you have given to this family. And so, Father, we know that when you would have given her to her family, you gave her as a gift. Not only to her family, but Lord, as a gift to the entire nation. That's why we would have had so many tributes and so many persons talking about how much she meant to them. Today, Father, as was already said, it's just her remains that is in this building, lying in this casket. We stand today, loving Father, having family members standing around this casket today. We know that you are God Almighty. Besides you, there is none other. And so we ask, O God, that they would feel your nearness. They would feel your comfort. They would know that you are with them. We come against any and everything, Lord, that can stand in the way. Anything that can cause division. Anything, loving Father, that can stand, Lord God, in creating confusion. We stand against the plans and the purposes of the enemy. And so, Father, we ask for your release upon the lives of this family. And even as we get ready to go to the cemetery where her remains will be committed to the ground, Lord, this in itself is another time, oh God, in the life of the family that is very painful. But we know that you are God. We can draw from you. You are a very present help in the time of difficulties. And that's why we are calling upon you today. I ask God Almighty for your special touch. Thank you, Father, for what you have already done and what you will do as we continue to depend on you. Thank you for your word to us today. May we respond positively to your word with the understanding, Father in heaven, that you give to us a second chance. Bless this family, members. We stand against every negative and everything that may try to exalt itself. We rebuke it, we destroy it, and we thank you, Father, for your release. Give them the strength that they need. We ask it today in Jesus' lovely name. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Bishop King. Thank you very much. Amen. At this moment, praise God, we turn you back to the cheerleader. Amen. God bless you.
Bless the Lord. We thank God for each and every one of you and those who have given your life to Christ. I want to encourage you to find a place of worship where you can fellowship and where you can grow and develop spiritually. Amen? Amen. Before we leave, anyone found the glasses that are reading glasses, that is, that dropped around? You can just bring it. You have it? You miss it? Yeah, so we're looking for reading glasses. Anyone found it, just bring it up to the podium. Thank you. Amen. I'm just going to call on one of the family members. I have to give a vote of thanks before we leave. Alicia?
Good afternoon to everyone. We, the Stephen family, would like to say a heartfelt thank you to Mr. Hugh Dollard, Honorable Ron Head, Redhead, Honorable Tevin Andrew, Management of FLOP, staff of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, staff of ASG, the Lalji family, and all who showed your support and love during this time of grief. We really want to say thank you. It means a lot to us. Thank you again, and thank you.
And thank you for thanking us. Amen? Hallelujah. Yes. So as we're about to head to the cemetery, we're going to sing the song, Creator of the Universe. Amen.
What can you do?
Father, we ask your blessings upon, Lord, this grave site in the name of Jesus. We pray, God, as we're about to lay Anika body into the tomb, we ask you, Lord, to take charge, complete control. Bless those who are here, Lord. Comfort their hearts as they mourn. We pray in the name of Jesus that you continue to let your will be done. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, amen. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I've fought a good fight. I've finished the course. I've kept the faith. And he said, naked I come out of my mother's womb. Naked I shall return thither. The Lord giveth, the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin the worms assured my body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see, and for myself, and not another, shall behold, and not another, though my reign be consumed within me. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall rise incorruptibly, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall I put on incorruption, and this mortal shall I put on immortality. Then shall it be brought to pass. It is written, death is swallowed up in the victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death, amen, is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be unto God, which give us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be always steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, inasmuch as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. For as much as it pleaseth Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world Anika Stevens. We therefore commit her body to the ground, to the tomb, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Undertaker. Right. Right.
Fire! Fire! Hallelujah. never let life problems let you down. See, when life problems come your way, hold your head up high and say, Hallelujah. If Jesus, I am an I am. Lift him up for the earth to see. He said, if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw men unto thee. For he's the King of kings, King of kings, and he's the Lord. Jesus, oh, he is the King.
Oh, he is the King of kings.
Hallelujah. Thanks God be no more.
And the morning brings eternal breath and fear.
God has got something else. So
when the Savior of the host shall gather over on the
earth. And the road is called up yonder, be there.
When the road is called up yonder. When the road is called up yonder. When the road.
This morning when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the burning of his resurrection shares, when his chosen ones shall gather from their home beyond the sky, and the road is full of yonder
happy.
When the road
seven sun, let us turn for all his wonders, love and care.
And when all of life is over and the work on earth is done, and the world is called up yonder,
when the world is called up yonder, when the world is called up yonder, when the world is called up yonder.
Oh,
That's it, Mason, man?
Mason.
That is it? Huh? Fanoi, okay. Okay. Give me a moment. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give you peace. May God bless each and every one as you continue to be encouraged. Continue to trust God and continue to look unto him for his help. Your help cometh from the Lord, which made the family together and caused them to be in unity with each other. May you continue to console yourself as you continue to mourn of your loss of your loved one. God bless you. Have a good evening.
God bless Jesus you too, Pastor.
Tomorrow may never be mine. This train is a holy train.
There we are. Oh, this train
Amen. Somebody shout it in Jesus' name. They stray, they stray. Oh, I can see